Hello, YouTube. Robert Alvarez, the Psychic Witch, also known as Mr. Lighting on a Fan. Good evening. Right now, the time is approximately 8:52 p.m., which does not numerologically reduce to 13, but I digress. And the date is Wednesday, April 8th, 2020. The sun is in Aries, and the moon is waning in Scorpio. So tonight's video is the April 2020 entry for Llewellyn's 2020 tarot calendar. I'm going to have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up of the cover of the calendar. And then I'm going to have him do a close-up of the featured image for April 2020, which is this. And alas, no, I do not have the Otherkin Tarot. But I will have Llewellyn's classic tarot for June 2020. Yes, unfortunately, my copy of Llewellyn's classic tarot was damaged. Unfortunately, it had help with two cats. I shall not name them. I'm going to pretend they feel chagrin that they contributed to the demise of my beautiful copy, which was a birthday gift by Queen Osette, also known as Oya's Girl. Thank you again for that beautiful birthday gift. That was one of the highlights of my birthday that year. That was January 2019, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it was. Or 2018, I don't remember. No, it was 2019, yes. Anyway, so I'm going to talk about, well, I'm going to read what Barbara Moore wrote about the Page of Cups. I'm going to read her blurb pages as messages, and then I'm going to I'm going to do the connecting with others spread. You know, I cannot help but notice the timeliness of when I'm doing these spreads. You know, and for the record, there is no spread for May 2020, at least in the Llewellyn's 2020 tarot calendar. I wish there was, because it depicts the High Priestess from the Arcanum Tarot. Not to be confused with the Arcus Arcanum Tarot, by the way. Anyway, so let me just dive on in. Page of Cups. The Page of Cups is just learning about relationships and connections with others. And he approaches them with enthusiasm and curiosity. He may get in over his head and will probably make mistakes, but that's how we learn. And I find it interesting that in this particular tarot deck, you will notice that the fish is holding the cup. In most traditional Rider-Waite-Smith oriented tarot decks, you will see a little boy holding a cup and a fish is above the rim of the cup. I'm going to have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up of this image. It's really unique in its variation on a traditional image of the Page of Cups. And of course, you know, it bears to say that traditionally pages represent young people, children, tweens, preteens, and for me, anybody under the age of 19, especially a water sign, and particular Pisces. But what I'm getting from, what I also get from this is that it's also about learning to navigate the slings and arrows, if you will, of relationships, romantic and otherwise. Pages as messages. Pages were traditionally associated with messages. Knights, by the way, traditionally are associated with messengers. The page's suit indicates what the message will be about. The Page of Cups. Thank you, Durga. Thank you, Durga. Thank you, Durga. The page's suit indicates what the message will be about. The Page of Cups might deliver a love letter. The Page of Swords might bring news about a legal case or decision. Also, Page of Swords would also indicate an electronic message, like an email, a text message, or a message. Ooh, you're that close to Isis? Oh no. That did not go well at all, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube. As I was saying, Page of Swords could be an email, a text message, a message via an app such as Viber, WhatsApp, Telegram, or even a message via a website such as Facebook, YouTube, like a YouTube comment, or a message via a direct message via Twitter or Instagram. Not that I accept direct messages via Instagram, by the way, thank you. The Page of Wands might bring a career offer, while the Page of Pentacles could bring information about a loan, a raise, or a bill, or maybe even an actual bill, like a $10,000 bill. This is Joss money, by the way. This is spirit money. I never gave the spirits money, which is ironic considering that I'm always asking, you know, the spirits for money. But, you know, it's like, yeah, the spirits need money in the afterlife. So, and our ancestors need money in the afterlife too. So I found this wonderful Etsy shop, Quandisha Arts, capital Q-A-N-D-I-S-A, capital A-R-T-S, spelled as one word. And she sells Joss money, spirit money. Although I do want to try the Chinese Joss money, which I need to order from the website where I first saw it. But yeah, I'm like, you know what? So I've been using this more often, especially on my Divine Prosperity altar. Yes, I have. Anyway, so when the pages come out in your readings, think about them like what the message is about, or what is the form of the message, or what is the nature of the intended message. And if the knight of the same suit comes along, then it's just confirmation that, yes, that is what the message is about. Okay, so connecting with others, I'm actually going to read what Barbara Moore wrote about the spread, and then I'm going to do the spread. So connecting with others is a 5-card spread, and it says relationships can be hard, and past experiences, in parentheses positive and negative, can influence present connections. Use this spread to break through a roadblock in a relationship. If possible, do this reading together to open an authentic dialogue. Blind spots are usually caused by unresolved wounds. Bringing these to light can help move communication forward. Now, one of the things that I'm always stressing the importance of is that relationships are not solely romantic. There is, given the nature of the Suit of Cups, it lends itself to personal, intimate relationships, romantic relationships, the potential for romantic relationships, former romantic relationships, but also close, intimate friendships and familial relationships. However, I'm divinely guided to do this spread for myself with regards to a professional relationship, not with regards to my professional psychic practice, but with my side position of employment. And fortunately for me, my awesome audiovisual person for my YouTube videos, who is also my amazing computer tech person for my electronics, is a very objective sounding board. So if there's anything that's skewed in my interpretation, he's going to point that out to me, right? And he's nodding his head, right. And I know exactly who the person is all too well. In fact, I received a text message from him today. Oh, I forgot to tell you that, by the way. Yeah, so. Okay, and the tarot deck that I'm using is one of my personal favorite tarot decks. It is called the Crystal Visions Tarot, and it was created by Jennifer Galasso. It's funny because in the video that I did for the April 2020 Many Moons Lunar Planner for 2020, I used an oracle card deck that I found out about through a longtime client. This is a tarot deck that I found out about through the same longtime client. So, I call upon the spirits of the universe. I call upon all celestial beings. I call upon Isis Fortuna, goddess of the sacred tarot, and by extension divination. I call upon my ancestors. I call upon all my spirit guides, my guardian angels, my Reiki guides, my psychic guides. I call upon all the elementals, and I call upon the powers of the universe to come down and be with me as I cast the cards right now. May this reading bring clarity and illumination, love and life, healing and wholeness, prosperity, protection and peace to all those who watch it. I cut the cards, and I'm going to start from the very beginning, from the top of the deck. With this reading, I am going to show you the card first, and then I'm going to show myself the card, and then I'm going to have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up, and then I'm going to read the card and all that other good stuff. I said that the wrong way, but it's okay. So, the first card, the problem, the essence of the conflict, which is in the center. It's flanked by two cards each, one on top of the other. But this is card number one, which is the problem, the essence of the conflict. So I'm going to show all of you the cards first. It is upright, correct? Okay. And I'm going to show all of you the back of the card design. Okay. Now I'm going to look at the card. It is the King of Swords. So the nature, the essence of the conflict is an extensive emotional detachment. And it's interesting because one of the things that I feel is important when one works under a supervisor is to receive encouragement from that supervisor. I feel that that is a very important component. And I feel that it's a very important professional practice of someone who is in charge of others, who supervises or manages or directs others. And I do not get that from my supervisor in my side position of employment. And it bothers the fucking shit out of me. It really does. Because I feel, and this is personally, I'm saying this just with regards to me. It could apply to you too. But I truly believe that if my supervisor in my side position of employment was more encouraging, I feel that I would have a better relationship with him professionally. And I also believe that I would be able to understand him better, and he would understand me better as well. And I think that I would do better in my side position of employment as well. Okay. And I'm going to take a brief pause. The video is going to keep running, but I need to turn off the coffee because it's very warm and I can smell it. And if I can smell it, that means it's, if I kept the burner on, it would burn. And you know, coffee is the specialty of La Casa de Roberto. Okay. The blind spot. What we're not seeing, because I'm doing this reading for myself, but it could resonate with you, so I'm saying us. Once again, I'm going to have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up of the card. And then I'm going to look at the card, and then I'm going to interpret the card. Okay. The blind spot, what we are not seeing, the Hierophant. We are not seeing the divine idea. We are not seeing the divine in this situation. And it's so funny because yesterday I was thinking about a beautiful and powerful and, in my experience, underused spiritual decree from the writings of Dr. Catherine Ponder. And it is, I behold you with the eyes of love, and I glory in your perfection. And I have come to realize that I have been a mortal with regards to this man. I have been a muggle, I've been a mundane, I have been a Cowan with regards to this man. And now I need to be a fucking witch. I need to be a badass bitch witch. I need to also do the witch bitch cackle, you know? Which I cannot do on command. I can do things like mwahaha on command, but I can't do my own command, mind you. Not anybody else's, mine, you know? I may not be that much of a control freak, but I'm still pretty much a control freak. Isn't that right? He almost nodded his head. He wants to nod his head, but he's like, I'm not going there. You can go there. It's okay. You really can go there. Uh-huh. Not that. You know, not. You're exaggerating now. Stop being melodramatic. So, I, you know what? It's time to get a sip of coffee. Sometimes you need to shove things in people's mouths to stop them from saying something. Sometimes we need to do it to ourselves. So yeah, so with regards to the situation, bring some magic into it. What is, and I ask you this, whether or not you are a witch or a magical practitioner, what is it that you have not been doing or using to bring triumph over this problematic situation? And by the way, card number two. So let's say this is the central card. Card number one. Card number two is, that would be the left. Here. They can see my torso, right? Okay. So that's card number two. So card number three is going to go here. Card number four is going to go here. Card number five is going to be here. But this is card number one. Okay. So card number three, the strength. What can help? So I'm going to show all of you first. I'm going to have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up. Then I'm going to look at the card. Why am I not surprised? Ace of Cups, new love energy. So what is your... And it's so appropriate because even though it's not the strength card is astrologically aligned with the sun sign Leo. Leo in Western astrology rules the heart, the physical heart, the heart chakra, and the spine. So technically, that never occurred to me. Technically, Leo rules the physical heart, the spine, and the spinal alignment of the seven major chakras. No wonder Jennifer Ball's spiritual, no wonder Jennifer Ball's of Jennifer Ball's Witch House, formerly Jennifer Ball's Spiritual Garage, is a chakra practitioner. It was astrologically ordained. There you go. Okay. So, I'm thinking about something that I read, and I remember it was in this particular book by Dr. Catherine Ponder, The Prospering Power of Love. Shoot them in the back with love. Like, visualize this, and you got to make it as out there as possible. Like, when I think of owning a gun, I think of a basic black Glock 9mm. But in my mind, what I'm seeing is that I need to take a big pink gun, like petal pink. Like rose petal pink. It's got to be a big ass gun, like bigger than like my this, twice the size of my hand, you know, big ass gun, rose petal pink, and out come heart shaped bullets, and I'm visualizing that supervisor with his back turned to me. No, Robert, be nice. And I'm taking my humongous pink rose petal pink gun. And shooting it, and shooting it, and shooting it. Now come these little hearts, these little beautiful puffy hearts, back on the back with love. I'm gonna smack the crap out of him, but I still am gonna do the visualization, no matter what. And we're doing a conference call tomorrow, so it will actually take place. Well, I will be literally in my mind shooting him in the back with love. Okay. The other's blind spot. What the fuck faces? Oops! What the what they are not seeing, what those people are not seeing. You know, the stupid one. Oops! Let me take another sip of some coffee. I keep saying things at the wrong time. I don't know why. Okay. Card number 4. The other's blind spot. What they aren't seeing. So again, I'm going to have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up first. I am going to turn it around, show it to me, and then interpret the card. The Tower. What are they not seeing? They're not seeing the value you provide. They are not seeing how much of a difference you make. And they're also not seeing that if they keep doing the same old bullshit over and over again, they're going to lose you. I hope he's listening. Okay. Card number 5. The other's strength. How they can help. What they can do to help. So again, I'm going to have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up of the card. And then I'm going to look at it. And then I'm going to interpret it. And here we go. 3 of Pentacles. They open doors. They bring about new opportunities. And that's their strength. And I gotta admit, my supervisor does have that strength, and I know that he has that strength. Yeah, he does. And the final message card, which is at the bottom of the deck. Once again, I'm gonna have my awesome audiovisual person do a close-up. And then I'm gonna look at the card. And the final message card is the Moon. So it goes back to your emotions. It goes back to my emotions. And it's so funny. All of a sudden, I began hearing Leo, the Halliwell sisters' white lighter. Your power comes from your emotions. So think about your emotions and think about your emotions in that situation. And you know what? It just so happens that I'm going to have a conference call with him tomorrow morning. So I know that prior to that conference call, I need to engage in a meditation where I ground and center my energies. And I begin to visualize him, and I begin to shoot him in the back with love. And I begin to say in my mind, I behold you with the eyes of love, and I glory in your perfection. I behold you with the eyes of love and glory in your perfection. I behold you with the eyes of love and glory in your perfection. So just a brief recap. Think about all of your relationships. Think about what relationship might be problematic for you. And I invite you to do this spread. I invite you to do a spread where you are examining this relationship from this perspective, from the connecting with others perspective, or the connecting with others spread perspective. And let me know if you do this spread, and if so, what comes up for you. You know, I would love to know that. I would love to know which tarot deck you used. I would love to know which cards came out. I would love to know what incense you gleaned or gained from it. And I would love to know if you have this calendar as well. Because you know what? I keep forgetting to ask all of you, do you have this calendar? So let me know in the comments. But in the meantime, YouTube, thank you so, so much for honoring who I am and what I do. And thank you so much for honoring Barbara Moore and the various artists and Llewellyn Publications and all they do too. And as always, I wish you a good night. I wish you many blessings. And remember, like, comment, share, and subscribe. And good night.